Hi everyone, welcome back to Google Developers Live. My name is Claudio and I'm one of the engineers in the Google Drive Developer Relations team. As you know, we recently launched communities on Google Plus, and we have a Google Drive Developers community where we have discussions about Google Drive development, new features, and anything that is related to Google Drive development. For today's GDL, we asked members of the community to ask their questions so that we could answer them live. We did that, I think, last week. So we have a number of questions we want to answer today. So let me get started with the first question. What I'm showing right now is the post that one of my teammates, Steve Basil, published last week asking for questions. And let's see, the first one is from Jeff, and he actually linked to a Stack Overflow question. So let me go to the Stack Overflow question and see what the question is like. The question is about making a copy of a Google Drive template by URL, obviously using the API, using the Drive SDK. I see that this question was already answered. Well, basically, I can just say that that's an interesting feature request. It's not a very common one. This is probably the first or the second time we get this feature request. So at the moment, there is no way to manage those templates with the API, but we will take this together with the other feature requests and see what we can do. That was pretty easy. One of my teammates answered. So. Let's go back. Arif asked if there is a layman's version of how to set up a static website. We covered this a lot in the last weeks. What we recently launched is a way for anyone to publish a static website on Google Drive. We think it's very easy. It is actually targeted not just to hardcore developers, but it's also targeted to advanced users or maybe like standard users. It should be very, very easy to do so. We have documentation, but we also have another GDL recording from November 29th called Google Drive SDK, Publishing Your Website on Google Drive, that explains how to publish a static website step by step. This is not for developers. We have other GDL Google Developers Live recordings that show how you can automate the process. But if you want a very, very basic version, so doing everything from the UI, not writing any code, this is what you should watch. So let me say it again. Google Drive SDK, publishing a website on Google Drive. You can find it on developers.google.com/live/drive. Or you can go to our documentation, which is at developers.google.com/drive. And search for our YouTube playlist. We have a playlist with all these recordings and all videos we recorded for the Drive SDK. So you can find this one there together with two more that we did that are about publishing a website on Google Drive. So we have a very basic one, this one. We have an advanced one, which is the one following this. And we also had a third one last week that was recorded with a community member that wrote his own application that integrates Hangouts with Drive. It's very cool. You should check that out. That's two. And by the way, I love this community because community members talk to each other, answer each other's questions. So Jeff, the same Jeff who asked the first question, replied to this other question. And so this channel is not just for us Googlers to answer your questions, but it's also for any of you to talk to others, compare your experience, and you know, share your tricks, answer other questions. This community is very active. We're very happy. We launched it slightly more than a week ago, I think, and we have 2,000 members, more than that, and we have a lot of threads. It's very interesting. If you're not there, you should definitely join it if you're interested. Then we have Nate saying two questions. First one, will Google Drive and Picasa integrate? This is a very good question. This is a very common question we get. And our goal is to provide users with the best experience. And we understand that the best user experience is merging Google Drive with Picasa. So the short answer is yes. The long answer is yes, we're working on it, and they will eventually merge. So we will keep you updated on this. Second question, how can one obtain public persistent thumbnails links for files? Right now, what you get in the file metadata is a short-lived thumbnail link. So whenever you want the thumbnail for the file, you should get the file metadata first and then check the thumbnail link, because that link might have changed. There is no way to get a persistent thumbnail link for files from the API. What we can say is, of course, you can store the thumbnail on your side. So you know that the thumbnail link will expire, but you go fetch it the first time, fetch the thumbnail, store it somewhere on your side, or even on Drive, on somewhere on your Drive account, and then serve it instead. I should also remind you that, you know, thumbnails can change, because anytime the user and the user that owns the file can change the thumbnail, replace it with a new one. So that's another reason why we don't have a static persistent thumbnail link, so that we force you to get a new one. And if the new one is changed, I mean, it's a new one, then you always get it instead of reusing the previous one. But if you don't mind risking that, you can always download the file first, the thumbnail first, store it on your side, whatever, even on Drive, and then use it. Let's see. Benjamin, I would really like the team's opinion on this, which I opened here. He said this is his most wanted feature for Drive. I don't know if it's very clear from the screenshot. What he's asking for is a feature that is available on Dropbox, which is an easy way to copy a public link to the doc. I think the question is in two parts. First, is there a way to get a public link for a doc for any file stored on Drive? And the answer is, of course, yes. And other people answered this thread by saying, yes, it's possible. You have to do this, this, and that. What he's asking is how to have an easy way to do that, like a right click, a single call, or something else. Just that makes it very, very easy. We don't have that, but we might think about it. So this is not a feature request we are going to take into account. So remember, there is a way to get a public link, and if you don't know how to do it, some other people answering this thread will explain how to do it, and it's basically going back to publishing a website on Google Drive. But for what concerns the easy, simple, right-click way, we don't have that. We might have that in the future. We'll talk more about it. Okay. Let's see what else. Jay, what's the status of the Drive API migrations between accounts? We need the ability to identify users shared on a file in order to replicate the accounts. So what's the point here? I think the context is of Google Apps domain, where domain administrators want to move files from an user to another. And right now, with the API, whenever you share something, we only address those users by IDs, unique IDs, but not email addresses. So for most cases, IDs are fine. For instance, when you're in this Google Apps domain environment, where you can know the user IDs for all users in your domain. In the broader case, you might have files shared to external users. They're not in the domain, and for those, you're not getting the email address. We are still working on this in the sense that we need to find the perfect trade-off between the functionality and privacy. So right now, all you get is the ID, and that is fine for most use cases. For instance, in the Google Apps domain case, you can use service accounts, and I also have a page here in our docs that explains how to perform Google Apps domain-wide delegation of authority. So with what is explained here, you can use service account as a domain admin to impersonate other users in the domain and act on behalf of them. This is usually what domain admins want or need. For what concerns the broader case, we're still working on the trade-off. So still, this is a common feature request, so this is not the first time we hear about it, and we have a lot of discussions about it. Please bear with us a bit more, and we will update you on what the decision will be. Just remember, this is a privacy concern, so we take it really, really seriously. Okay, Alan. Is there a reason or explanation that docs that are in a public folder on Drive aren't accessible using googledrive.com? I would say no, because I mean, files that are in a public folder on Drive are accessible using the same website publishing method that we just mentioned a few times today. So let's go back to our docs. We have a page dedicated to publishing website content on Drive. The requirements are that you set the folder as public. And according to the question, the folder was public, so I'm surprised. And when you do, the folder metadata will include a field called web view link, which will give you the base URL for all files in that folder. So this is an example. Assuming that the folder ID is A1, B2, blah, 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 the web view link will look like this, https://googledrive.com/host/folder ID. And for instance, if you have images in that folder, your full complete URL to the image will be googledrive.com/host/folder ID/images/kittens.jpg. So there is a way to publish files from a public folder, and they're accessible from googledrive.com when the folder is public. So if I understand the question correctly, I mean, the question is probably not 100% correct, because I mean, files are available. We also got some other questions in other threads, so I also added them here. One of those is there an example or tutorial for integrating Google Drive and Android? Yes. We really, really care about the Android developer community using Google Drive. And that's why we recently published a quick start. And we also recorded another GDL video explaining how to build your first Google Drive application on Android. And this is also linked in this Google Plus post. So if you follow the link, you will see that we published a post on our blog, which is Google Apps Developer Blog, that explains it very concisely. But then it takes you to the Quick Start Guide, which is a step-by-step tutorial that starts from the very basics, so the how to set up your environment, Eclipse, and everything, and enabling the Drive API, creating an Android project, adding the API, the libraries you need. There is sample code here, that's all it takes. And at the end of the page, if you don't like reading, you can also watch this video that does all these steps for you. So you can see, well, it's actually me doing all of that and explain step by step how you can write your Android application your Drive application on Android. So we have that, and it's a very popular page. A lot of people are watching it, are watching the video and checking the docs. So if you haven't already, you should check that out. I think I have a few more questions. This one was on Stack Overflow, and someone linked it on our community. The question is very simple. Is it possible to search within a Google Drive folder using the Google Drive SDK? Yes. It is possible and it's very easy. We have a simple query language that you can use in your Google Drive GET requests. And this is our page in the documentation. It's called Search for Files. It should be pretty easy to find. And we explain all you can do here, and we have a lot of examples. And one of the examples, it's exactly on how to search for something that is in a specific folder. And it's very easy. The query you have to do, it's folder ID in quotes. So in this case, we are assuming the folder ID is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and parents. Parents is the collection of folders containing the file. So when you write this query, you're saying, I want all files that are in this folder with ID 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So Claudio, for those on the live stream, could you go ahead and increase the font so we can see those?
Oh,
queries?
Sure. Okay. Sorry about that. So this is the page I was talking about. This is a search for files. And so this is how you search for files in a specific folder. And you can combine it with other search criteria. So for instance, you can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in parents, and title contains goodbye. You can put that together. And what that means is they're searching for all files in that specific folder with title containing goodbye. So this is how we search for files in a specific folder. And finally, let me make this bigger, I have the last question. The question is, what about enhancing the share function on the G Drive mobile app? Currently, we can only share files and folder with email addresses, but the file remains private. You can choose to make it public, which is not convenient. So you can definitely share a file or a folder with public using the API. I will check the mobile app. I'm not sure that it's not there. If it's not, you can always write your own application that uses the Drive API. So remember, with the Drive API and with the desktop UI, you can definitely share something with the public. I will double check this. I'm not sure if it's in there or not. I didn't check, but it's a feature we have. So it's something you can do with the API. So if it's not there, we can probably add it later, or you can write your own application to share something with the public. Okay, and I think that was the last question I had for today. Remember, anytime you have a question, feel free to write on the Google Plus community we have. And if the question is very technical, so if you're showing code, Stack Overflow is even better for that. It's the specific community. It's a developer-oriented community. My team and I are always on Stack Overflow and on the Google Plus community. So feel free to choose the one that's better for your questions. And if we like this session, we can always do more when we answer your questions live. And if you want to ask your questions live, we can also do that. Last week, we had a member of the community joining us to present his application. So if you want to do that, if you want to showcase your app, if you want to talk to us live, just ask. We'll be happy to have you on Google Developers Live. And with that, I wish to see you next time. Remember, we are live every Monday and Thursday. But remember, there's also a lot of other contents on Google Developers Live every single day. Thank you. See you next time.